welcome back to Warm Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on the Dodge Journey. And what we'll show you guys, okay, how to remove and replace front door actuator. Now, that same Dodge Journey, guys, is known as Fiat Fremont in the rest of the world. So practically the same car under two different names. Now, let me show you what I'm talking about, what we'll be replacing today. We'll show you on the front door, doesn't matter if it's front left, front right, how to remove, okay, and replace the door lock actuator. Okay, this is door lock actuator right here. Okay, it's on the back side, so we have to do quite a bit of disassembly to get to it. Stay with us, that's what we'll be doing, guys. In the meantime, okay, we're going to have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe to the channel. Our mission is to save you as much money as we can, so let's start on it now. So we need a plastic panel removal tool now, okay, and we're going to remove the window switch first. Okay, you need to push in, get underneath it, pry it up. It has, I believe, four clips holding in place. Okay, check it out now, and we need to disconnect the wires. And the easiest way to disconnect them, okay, you can see those are the wires, guys. Okay, that thing in the middle, push on it, okay, and pull the wire out. Perfect, one, and then one more. And that's the window mirror switch coming out. Now, what else we need to do? Right here, we need to remove that cover. Okay, you can see there is one cover. Just pull it up like that. Now, under the door handle, there is another cover. Okay, perfect. We remove that one as well. So, you can see this one, it looks like it's a Torx 30 bit, okay, like this one here. And we're going to go ahead, remove that that bolt, that screw now. Okay, bolt. Right here, we have two more. Okay, one is a Phillips screwdriver, one is a 10 millimeter socket. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and we'll grab the socket and the Phillips screwdriver. Okay, let me explain. I'm talking about this bolt right here and the one over here. the big one is holding for sure, but I think the little one too. So let's double check everything. That way, guys, you don't break your car while you're trying to fix it. So, okay, 10 millimeter here. That screwdriver set is extremely good. Check it out, guys, we'll have it listed in the description of the video below. Nothing sponsored here, guys. All the tools and parts are purchased by us. All we do is trying to tell you what's good, what's not, what it's worth the money, what it's not, and all that stuff. Bolt, out of the way. Now, let's remove that screw. Okay, very short screw. So let's see, okay, if anything else is holding that handle now. Okay, that plastic just comes out like that. The handle stays inside. Perfect. Now, let's see, guys. We're going to get a plastic panel removal too again, and we'll start prying here and there. Okay, you need to start it on one side, that you find a little bit of a gap that you can get the tool in. Okay, and you need to pry the door open. Okay, you can see the clips started coming loose. They'll be really tight. Once you make a little bit of space, you can grab it with your fingers. Okay, and pull it up. Now let's see right here, I believe. Okay, we need to go up. But to make sure, okay, we go up just a little bit. Okay, and slide it out. Now, what do we need to do here, guys? Okay, we need to go ahead. Okay, and disconnect the, this is the door lock, the door handle cable here. Okay, so let me just get a good angle so I can show you what we need to do. Now, what we found, the easiest way to remove now is, okay, there is one clip, you squish it in. Okay, and the door handle will separate, okay, from the door panel. Let us explain you now. This is the clip right here. So what we have to do, squeeze them in towards each other and pull the handle out. That way, okay, you can pull the panel. Now we have one more. Okay, one more wire here. This is for the lights. Okay, you have the little bitty lights here that illuminate. So we need to disconnect this one now. Okay, by pressing down and pulling out, and the panel is out of the way. Let us show you now where all the clips are, guys. Okay, and we're going to show you, okay, where you can get some clips from if you break them. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 clips that hold that door panel in place, as you can see. So now for the exterior door handle, guys. This is your handle, right? Okay, right here. Now, if you open the door, okay, you're going to notice that you have, one tape right here that we need to grab with our fingers, okay. And you need to gently remove, okay, this thing is going to break, I believe. Okay, I'll just leave it like that. And there is a small screw inside. I will not be able to show you guys. Okay, let me grab a light quick so we can show you. Okay, little bitty Torx screw. Okay, right there, this is it. So this one looks like a Torx 15 maybe. Okay, so let's check it out quick. This is a Torx 15 screwdriver. Or maybe it's a Torx 20. Okay, because 15 is a little bit loose. So let's check it out. You don't want to strip that screw. Okay, Torx 20, start. Okay, start unscrewing. And grab that cylinder lock as well. Okay, oh, perfect. A little bit more. Okay, that's it. Cylinder lock came out. Okay, like that. So this is out now. Let us show you, okay, that screw, guys. Okay, you cannot actually, it's pushing that piece here, I believe. Okay, trying to see where it is. Now, how you guys remove the handle? Okay, let me show you quick. You need to grab the handle, okay, slide towards the back. Slide towards the back. Okay, and let's see if it's going to come out now. Or we need to do something else. So this cap, guys, right here, now you can open it once you have the door panel removed. Okay, and okay, check this thing out now. Okay, this metal thing, okay, right here, you need to grab it with your fingers. Okay, I'm trying to fit the camera in here. Okay, and pull it up. Okay, you have to pull it up all the way up. Okay, the same like you're opening the door handle. Okay, see what's going to happen, but you need to push it quite a bit up. So let's get somebody, okay, to hold the camera here quick. Okay, and I'm going to push that metal thing up all the way as much as it goes. Then the handle will come out. You can pull it this way and you can disconnect it. Okay, you can see that metal thing, okay, right here that I'm moving. Now, we can go ahead actually, okay, and let's see. Okay, if we have anything else holding the handle here or not. So you can see, guys, we have the smart handles here. So what we have to do, we have a wire, okay, and that wire, okay, it's all the way inside right there. There is one connector. Okay, you can see it by that green thing. So we need to go ahead and disconnect it. I won't be able to show you how to get it, but I'll explain once I remove it and show you the connector. Okay, guys, this is the connector for the handle. You can see that's what it looks like. You press on this side, okay, and you pull it out like that. Now, if we grab the handle, we can pull it out. Okay, it comes out in
one specific way. Okay, now we cut the wire connector that I need to guide through here. So, okay, just like that. This is the connector, this is the handle, you can see like that. So, that's how you guys remove it. Okay guys, so with the Torx 20 bit, okay, start looking bit, we'll need to remove the speaker now. This one will be the next step. And we're going to leave the screws on the speaker so we don't lose them. How we disconnect that thing, guys, let me show you right here. Okay, you just press down and pull it out. Okay, like that. Now what we need to do, we need to install our window switch. And we need to bring the window down, I think, to the point that we can actually go ahead and disconnect the window from the regulator. So, okay, we need to turn the ignition on. Now we will start bringing the window down a little bit more. Okay, on this side I can see. Okay, right here is the point where it disconnects on the bottom, on the back side. And let's see if we can reach this one here now. Okay, so we need to do one at a time from what it seems like. Okay, that's where this one is. So what we did, okay, we brought the window on the left side to here. I went on the inside, grabbed it on the back side, and there is a clip. You need to spread it this way, and one person needs to lift the window up at the same time. Okay, like that. Okay, and the window came loose, you can see, so we can leave it like that. Now we have to gently keep the window to make sure it doesn't go in, and we need to bring it down to the other point now. Okay. Through the speaker to disconnect the other one. So this one, okay, right here, let me show, if you go like that, okay, we can reach it through here. Spread it and pull up. Okay, and it got unhooked. Okay, so you can see it came out of the white thing. We can lift it up now a little bit. Okay, it came out of the holders. It's loose on the other side. Now we can go ahead and pull the window out. Okay, in an angle. Okay, like this one. Next, we're going to go ahead and remove the window motor here. With the Torx 25, start looking bit like this one there. Okay, we need to pull it out and disconnect the wire. Now how we disconnect this wire? That safety pin, push it to the outside, push in there and disconnect. Okay, like that. Now we can proceed, guys, with what we need to do next now. And we need to get a 10 millimeter socket. Okay, but first I believe we need to unlock this. This is with a Torx, with a Torx 25. We'll do them by hand. Okay, it says, you can see, unlock and lock, or 30, Torx 30. All the tools and parts, guys, will be listed in the description of the video below. Okay, like that. So we have all together four. Okay, like that, and one on top. Okay, perfect. Now we need to remove the bolts with the 10 millimeter socket. One bolt, two, three, Okay, four. Five, and one more under the cap there. So it looks like we have six balls. Okay, let's see if we have anything else holding here. Okay, a little bit there on the bottom in the holders. Okay. Okay, it's still holding a little bit, so what we'll do, we'll disconnect all the cables now so we can move it a little bit more. Okay, we have the airbag cable here, the airbag connector. Okay, this one, let's see if we can pry it out. It's easier if you pull the sensor out, but without it, it's a little bit more complicated. We have one holder here. Okay, that we just pulled out like that. This is the mirror wire. Okay, we need to squeeze that thing in and just pull it out. Okay, like that. Now, we're going to see what else we have here and if we can gain a little bit more room. Okay, to move around. Okay, so let's see if that will give us a little bit more room to pull to the side. No. And we have, it looks like it might be holding. Okay, the door lock actuator might be holding that one. There is a bracket right here that if you pull too much, you're going to break it as well. So you have to be careful there. Okay, it's trying to come loose on the front side, but the rear it's still holding. It looks like it's coming with the actuator. Okay, next with the Torx 30, we're on the outside door handle now again. Okay, we're going to get this one loose. Okay, just a little bit. Now, there is one right here. That looks like we need to remove as well. Perfect. And after that, okay, you can see, guys, we have one, two, three of those here. Look like those are not even tight on ours, I don't know why. We just noticed that they're loose. Probably got loose from vibrations. You can use some thread locker as well on those. Okay, the handle now, I'm going to pull that rubber seal out so we don't lose it. Now I'm going to, okay, let's see if we can push that thing out, okay. It's going to slide here, come out. Okay, like that. Now, okay, you can see the regulator on top is holding a little bit, so we need to drop it down. And everything looks like it's coming loose here now. Okay, guys, and that came loose now. So next, if you need to replace the door handle mechanism or the actuator, the procedure will be practically the same. So you can see right here, that tube, you need to pick it up. Okay, you need to disconnect. Okay, both of them like that. Okay, how you disconnect that thing, guys? Okay, you have two options. Okay, right here, you can twist it like that. Okay, and pull it out. Okay, you can see it like that. The only thing left now to actually remove the actuator, there are a few plastic clips, okay, like right here, that hold it in place. So all you have to do, okay, you can see right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 clips. Okay, push those out and the Okay, the regulator will come out. Also, if you need to disconnect the cable here, you just pull that thing out and disconnect it as well. Pretty much it's simple from that point on, depending what you need to do. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you trying to replace a door lock actuator or a door handle mechanism, because it could be, okay, it could be a little bit frustrating not to know what to do. But you can see from that point on, it's pretty simple. That's the only thing. Okay, only the clips holding the actuator now. So, thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.